praying that God would use our family, not in a million years praying for, you know, to lose a child, but, you know, it's one of those things when you, you know, when you decide to give your heart and life to Christ, either you're going to live it and walk the walk and talk the talk, or, you know, when bad times come, you're going to fold and run.
He's the God who gives and takes away.
My name is Landon Holmes, and I've been with Smith Auto Group since March of 2010, so it's been 5 years this month. And right about the time I was hired, we had a little five-year-old little girl. Her name was Layton Nan Holmes, and she started complaining of headaches, and we just thought it was no big deal. We took her to a doctor, and she was fixing to start kindergarten, so they thought it was just her having anxiety, or maybe some migraines. But they told us to keep track of, you know, when it was happening.
So when I think back to June of 2010, Layton was going to start kindergarten in the fall, and we really just started praying that God would give her a love for others and that God would use her to show His love and to bring others to Him. And as a family, we began praying every night that God would use our family to make our faith real to others.
Friday morning on August 6th, I got up to come to work. We had family over the house the night before, so that was a blessing that we didn't know at the time. It was actually my cousin that called me and said that they couldn't get Layton to respond, get her to wake up.
When I found Layton that August morning, she had been in our bed asleep since we had family at the house, and she was in one spot, and I tried to wake her up, and she just kind of rolled around, and so I let her sleep a little bit, and then when I came back in a few minutes later, she had moved to another spot in the bed, and I tried to wake her up, and she just kind of mumbled and rolled back over, and so I let her sleep for a little bit, and I went back in at 8:32 in the morning and told her it was time to get up. We were going to take the cousins to the zoo that day before they went back home, and I couldn't get her to wake up, and I just shook her, and she wouldn't wake up, and he carried her outside for me, and as he did, she started turning blue, her lips were purple, and she was, you could tell she was trying to say something, but she just couldn't get anything out, and her she just became unresponsive very, very quickly. When we got to St. Edward's, I remember getting out of the ambulance, and it just hit home that this is not going to be good. And they took us into the room, and they already had a family room for us. And when you know that there's already a family room before you arrive, it's not going to be good.
They did a CAT scan and said there was definitely some bleeding on the brain. They didn't know why, they didn't know what it actually was, so they made the decision to airlift her to Children's. And so we got all of our family together, we started that trip to Children's. There's one thing that, you know, like I said, you'll never forget, just watching your little girl just taken by helicopter, just watching that helicopter disappears into the sky. So
never forget, as they put her in the helicopter, and the wings are going in the helicopter, and you can just feel the wind just about knock you over. That was the angels of heaven welcoming her home, just the fire picking up the wind, and it's something you never forget. And we got to Little Rock, and she was in the MRI when we arrived, and it was several hours before we got to see her. And when you walk in this room, and you see your little bitty baby in this big old bed, and just tubes everywhere, and she was just hooked up to everything, and IVs in her, both her hands and her legs, and we just knew something wasn't right, but we still thought we were gonna get the answers, and they could do this corrective surgery, and she'd wake up, and we'd be home in a few days.
They had already drilled a hole to try to release some of the pressure, and they said it didn't do what they wanted it to, so they ended up doing an MRI, and they said there was a tumor at the base of her brain. And it had fallen down into the hole at the bottom of her skull. And so by this time, all of our family had pretty much made it to Children's Hospital, and they told us it would just be a waiting game. So we were waiting and, of course, praying.
One of the nurses had cut her hair, and I remember telling the nurse, you're going to get in trouble because Layton had cut her hair previously, but it's finally grown out in time for school. And I thought, here we go, now we're going to go to kindergarten with chopped up hair, and her bow's not gonna work, and I remember the nurse looking at me thinking, honey, you have no idea what's going on, and she was just so solemn.
The doctor said we needed to wait and do a, I forget the name of the test, but some type of 7-12 step test to see if her brain was functioning. So they did those tests, and of course none of them came back positive.
We just continued to pray and ask God to give us a miracle, and you know, and if God needed Layton, then to take her.
And every tear I've cried, you hold in your hand. You never left my side.
That night around 11:15, I was in her room, and I was just singing some songs with her, just Jesus Loves Me and the V.I.B.L.E. and Father Abraham. And I just remember thinking, okay, she's going to wake up. And she kind of jerked her arm a little bit, and I got excited. And Landon's brother came in, and he started singing, and he noticed that she was moving a little bit. And so we got real excited. And a few minutes later, everybody was in the room. So we probably had 20 people in the room, just packed. And we were just singing loud as we can. And we were thinking, okay, anytime she's going to wake up, she's going to wake up. And I remember our nurse was out in the hallway, and she was just a blessing from God. She was with us every step of the way, and she's like, just keep singing, keep singing. Well, she didn't wake up, but it was just a time I'll never forget. In the hardest time of your life, you're standing there with your baby, and you're singing songs to Jesus. And we had some other families that were in the ICU with us, and they kept hearing us sing, and they'd come to the door wanting to know what we were doing while our kids in ICU, and they could hear us singing songs and praising God. And so just to see right there that our lives and Layton's story was already affecting people, it gave us some peace that we didn't have.
We ended up making the decision that next day to pretty much take her off life support, because they had done a blood dye test and said there was basically no blood going to her brain. So all throughout the night, we were in her room, you know, singing songs and praises. And you know, that was just the first example of how God was using our family during that time.
Happy birthday to Jesus. Happy birthday to you.
So our pastor came up to us, because he had made the trip down, of course, and he said, you know, when y'all get a chance, we want you to share your story, you know, in front of the church. And we said, we'll do it tomorrow, you know.
I said, how about tomorrow? And Brother Mike kind of looked at me kind of crazy. I said, well, we'll be there in the morning, and if we're going to start telling our story, then we need to start now before the devil gets a hold of us.
If we're going to start using our story to glorify God, then we're going to start right now. So
we told Layton goodbye, and we left, and it was the hardest thing to walk out the hospital knowing that your baby was upstairs. We got home about 11:30 Saturday night. And I was hoping that Molly would be asleep, so I just didn't have to think about that. And of course, she was awake, and she met us outside, and she said, where's my sissy? And we just told her she was in heaven, and she said, it's okay. God took care of her. And so Molly knew in her own way, God had given her the peace already.
I'll never forget walking in the church that next morning. Of course, we were a little late, and it was just packed. And we stood up there and, you know, gave our testimony. And then you go on to visitation. It was just the same thing. The room was just packed, and you know, we just had this peace about it. It's not that it was an easy thing to do, but you know, there were people just coming to us and saying, you know, how are you staying strong? How are you not broken down? And we said, you know, it's not us. It's God shining through us.
I'll never forget how beautiful she looked, and you couldn't see the scar on her head where they had put the tube in, and they had fixed her hair where she had a hair bow, and her pretty dress, and she just looked beautiful. She was five. We were praying that five people would come to accept Jesus as their Savior for the funeral, just to celebrate, you know, her fifth birthday. As much as it stinks to lose a child, if there would not have been that funeral that day, those 21 people would not have accepted Jesus.
Not to say that we, you know, liked what happened, that it was our choice, but we give God all control of our lives, and then we have to make the decision to choose to see good. It's not something that happens. We're all affected by bad things in our life, you know, whether it's, you know, drugs, alcohol, you know, abuse, divorce, losing a job, anything. But we have a choice in that moment to see good in everything, and that's what we chose to do.
Though the questions still fog up my mind, promises I still.
This will be our fifth year. We've been doing a 5K in memory of Layton. And each year we donate the money to a local or to a nonprofit. The first 3 years We did local organizations in the last 2 years, and this year's we're doing an organization called While We're Waiting. While We're Waiting, they're more of like a, you know, the spiritual side, you know, asking the tough questions, because there's so many questions that parents who lose kids have. So this last year we raised about $13,000 for them, and this year we're hoping to do about the same. So and that's what we want to do. We just want to raise money. We want to keep Peyton's legacy alive. You know, just share our story and use, you know, our storm for God's glory.
Scattered words and empty thoughts.
We appreciate that. I mean, we love when people step up, and, you know, it just helps Layton's legacy just to live on. You know, like I said, the good that comes from it, and that's what we're interested in. And it doesn't happen by itself. It happens because of, you know, people like Smith Auto Group, and like I said, they've been one of the, you know, businesses from the very get-go that
washing away my.
While We're Waiting, we'll appreciate it. They're fixing to start building their own retreat center. So I know this. So this will go.
Really cool.
This will be tremendous in helping them do that. That's one thing, you know, we found most helpful, just being there for people. And that's one great thing about While You're Waiting. They actually have their own Facebook page, which I'm sure you saw, and it's just for parents that have lost kids. You have to be accepted to that. Of course, it's a group that nobody wants to belong to, but John Smith and the rest of the Auto Group family have done amazing.
Jesus loves me.
Good. What's A stand for? God.
God loves us to send his son.
Good. What's B?
B is...
All
has sin.
And what's C?
While we're sinners, cross stars for us.
You're awesome. Smile.
You know, you hear that, you know, people, kids that lose parents are called orphans, and if you lose your spouse, it's a widow, a widower, but there's not a term for somebody that loses a kid.
Since we've lost Layton, God continues to bless us. We've added two more girls to our family, Landry and Mary Beth. And we are also an open foster home, so we get to share the love of God to kids that come in and out of our homes.
Oh, all we nations rise, voice of turn about the sky. With the dear workers and kids, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
Yeah. Your grace fall like rain from everything.